Hey guys, coming to you from Kristen's Kitchen. Today I'm going to be making some Guyanese dal curry. I just want to show the ingredients that I have here. I have one large hot pepper, 2 teaspoons of jeera cumin. I have 1 teaspoon of garlic seasoning here, powdered seasoning, 2 teaspoons of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of yeast. And with the yeast, this is the first time I'm actually using yeast in these ingredients. I have 6 cloves of garlic. I have some. So here we go, guys. I'm gonna be blending this up into my food processor. This is a little bit tricky, so you just do it a little bit at a time. This has to be ground up very, very finely. Ahead, you're gonna be hearing some noise now. Okay guys, as you can see, I've done a bit of it here. It's now grind up like powder. I'm going to just finish off the finishing touches. While this is in here, I'm going to add the hot pepper in here. So everything is going to blend up in here. So this is the last bit of the peas here. Okay guys, let's go ahead and put all the mixture into this peas. I managed to crush the garlic with this mortar. This has to be crushed very fine. So we're gonna go ahead and add all the ingredients in here, including the garlic, the salt, the cumin, and the ingredients. Garlic that I crushed up, and you guys can actually blend this garlic up very fine with a food processor, but I decided to use this little device that I have. It goes in there. We're gonna add the curry powder and the turmeric. So guys, here we go. This is the dough that I've just finished. So I've got all the, mix it up nicely. What I'm gonna do is put some onion, garlic, some flour in there. And we're gonna cover this with a damp cloth. So it raises a little bit. There you go. A damp cloth. Put at the side. Then we're gonna leave that for like 15 minutes, let it rise, and then we're gonna go come back to it. Okay guys, here's the flour here. This is the dough that I left for a couple of minutes. I'm going to take everything out here. On there, and we're going to get working down here. Just sprinkle a little bit of flour. We're going to know we're going to cut this up in different sections, small volume sections. Cut up in four sections. I do it like this because it'll make it easier.
This ornate structure is a bathhouse. Fed by natural thermal springs, it was built by the Romans in the 1st century AD. One of only two surviving Roman baths, they still have hot water running.
So here we go. Make some smaller balls. Cut this in two pieces.
A luxurious home built by wealthy Londoners 1500 years after the time of the Romans. Keen to sample the curative properties of Bath natural hot springs, they came, they saw, and they brought their children architecture. The town's distinctive honey-hued Palladian buildings contribute to Bath's unique air of timelessness and make it a favorite filming location. Beverly's carriage may be limited to one horsepower, but who needs speed? 16-year-old Star provides this time-honored form of transport with something better. Personality. And a chance for Pamela and Kate to live a dream of time. All that's missing is a fairy tale castle. A great labyrinth formed by 2,400
Okay, I've got 22 pieces here, and I think this is enough. Okay guys, let's get ahead and make this. So what we're gonna do is do like this here, because we have to make like a ball to try to stuff the peas in a...
The Memorial Day ceremony is held here to honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice.
do it like this here. You make in a ball, you can make it like a little well. You just do it like this. Make a ball in your hands.
Teams of four compete much of the ancient Persians did 2,000 years ago.
Fill this here with peas now. And all we need is I'm using this sound. Ice cream scooped. So we just need one scoop in there. We don't need too much. We don't need to overwork this. Just do like this here. Make sure you get it in. The trick here is try to get all the bits in. Make sure it's do it like this here. So flatten it down a little bit. This is how it should be. So the peas is in there. Keep doing this until you've finished with all the.
Which places Jamie in rather privileged company. Not to mention the adrenaline rush of the world's most exclusive sport.
Push it down with your hands. Make sure everything gets in there. And just cover it. Just keep blending it in your hands.
From here in 1497, the explorer John Cabot sailed for the New World, becoming the first European since the Vikings to land on mainland North America. During the 18th century, however,
finishing up all the rest here.
From 1700 to 1807, the infamous Bristol slave trade carried around 500,000 human captives from Africa to the Americas. This bridge, spanning Bristol Harbor, commemorates all of them. But it is named after one, Harrow Jones, an enslaved African who served the household of 18th century slaver John Guinea. In the Bristol of Harrow's lifetime, the voice of dissent was rarely heard. Thankfully, that is no longer the case. In this city, street art has long since become a voice to be recognized. Bristol's urban landscape was the first canvas.
Just keep doing this until everything is covered up.
Thanks. His hometown features dozens.
I'm gonna go ahead and finish up all of these here.
The pastiche of the famous Vermeer painting.
So we want to get this stove, the stove top.
Just me here.
Here?
Can I see?
Can you what? You gotta move the table now.
Can you bring past me one of them things in here? Wrong thing. This is blackened.
Well, you gotta take this out of here. You want this stuff?
Yeah, I wanna put it.
Just put it here. I don't care to do anything.
Okay, there we go.
Good?
So we got stuff going on here.
So when you're ready, all you gotta do is click start again, like what's here.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I'm ready.
Well, you click start when you're ready, I gotta move for me one anyway.
This one. Yeah, I could see perfect. The lighting is good. I'll cook it when I put this one. It's on?
Okay.
Here we go. So, let's continue. Hi guys, here we go again. I'm just about wrapping up here. I just free. I've got like 10 more to go and I'm good. I've made 22. Hey guys, I just wanted to show you the dalpuri I've just finished, and this is it here. See, look how nice and soft it is. So I'm gonna cover this now. Cover this with a. Try to keep it nice. And you know, what I'm gonna do? The rest. Of, I have some flour left back. I'm gonna make something called sada roti. So I will show you exactly what I'll be doing. Rest of the flour that's left back, and I'm gonna make 2 sada roti with this here. Here we go, guys. This is the sada roti I'm making. So as you can see, start to swell, turn it over. It's not quite finished yet. I'll just cover this here. This is remaining of the flour mixture that I had, the flour dough. So I'm just trying to make use of that. Hey guys, I'm back with you with this dalpuri. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to wrap this dalpuri individually. Because my friend Jeanette is coming to pick some up. So this is how you wrap it. Just fold it like this here. And you just wrap it. Wrap it. Wrap it like this. Just keep it nice and moist. Hey guys, what I have here is some, this is the dalpuri, and I have here some mango sour with cucumber and hot pepper. So I'm going to just put a dab on here. And you just roll it like this. And you can eat it just like that. So there you go. Dal puri with mango sour. Okay, guys, this is a sada roti. See, I've just cut it open. And I'm going to put some butter in it.